Hello everyone, Amod here from the Target Common YouTube channel, and this video will be continuation to Karate Framework playlist. In the last video, we will learn basics of data-driven testing in Karate Framework, and in this video, we will learn how to achieve data-driven in Karate Framework using CSV and JSON files. So whatever examples we seen in the last video, we were passing the data in the examples table. It is not easier to pass the data from examples table all the time. If your payload is really big, you have more number of columns, then it will be really nightmare to add or update the values. So instead of passing the rows in examples table, we can use any external file like CSV or JSON. So the first part, we have how to create the CSV and JSON file for this examples table. This is first row of data and this is another row of data. These all are a list of data. So following the same concept, we need to create the JSON file. This will be one JSON object, this will be another JSON object, and both JSON objects we need to put into a JSON array. And for the CSV, the column names will be row and these will be data rows, means this will be first set of data and this will be another set of data. So I'm going to use this mockaru.com to generate CSV and JSON file for my example. Here I have already added the field names like name, ID, age, manager. You need to provide the type. So automatically it will generate some random data for you. And I want only two rows, and here you can select the format JSON or CSV. So let me quickly show you the preview of JSON. Here you can see it is generating one set of data. This will be another set of data and everything inside is JSON array. And if I select CSV, here you can see it is showing the data as row and column. If you select this row, you can see it is comma separated thing. You can generate the data. So let me click on generate data. It will download a CSV file for me. Same thing, I am going to generate a JSON data as well. So here I have copied CSV and JSON file in my payloads folder of this project. Now let's see how can we pass this JSON and CSV as an example. I think I have given some different variable names here, so I am going to use the same thing. So here I will use name, because we know that we can use the column names in my scenario outline description as well. Here for this name, I am going to use the name variable, and thing for ID we have the same thing. For manager, we have the variable name as age manager, and here I'm going to simply remove these two things as of now. And instead of passing all these things, we just need to pass one row, and here I need to use the read method, and in this read method I need to pass the location of the file. This payloads folder has my CSV and JSON file, and this feature file where I am writing this scenario outline is in airline. So when we keep any file path here, it will try to search within this airline. So my JSON file is present inside this payload folder. So I need to give the path in quotes as payload slash my file name with the extension. Let me run this scenario and show you the output. So here you can see it is reading the data from JSON file for both the rows. Let me show the report also how it is showing. So if you click on this link, so here you can see we have one feature file. If you open this feature file, we have total two scenarios. Total two scenarios means we have two rows of data, that's why it has executed twice. And if you expand it, everything you can see. In the last video we learned that we have a magic variable underscore underscore raw, which will give me the currently executing row as a JSON object. Let me print that variable here. I will run it. So here you can see JSON doc and the magic variable are giving you the same result. Here we have used the angular brackets, but we can use the embedded expressions as well. So let me quickly show you that. Let me run this and show you the output. So here you can see it is giving you the similar output. We know that when we pass any column as null, then embedded expression will only remove that. Let me remove this field. I am not passing null, but I have simply removed that field. If I run the scenario now, if you go to first row, here it has not removed this field. It didn't find the ID. So it is giving the same thing whatever we have hard coded here. Underscore underscore row is giving the correct one, because we have only this much in my JSON file. So here, instead of removing the field, we need to pass null to it. Then embedded expression will automatically remove that ID field from the JSON doc. Let me run this again. So here you can see it has not included the ID, but this magic variable will give you ID as null, because it will give you the original thing. It will not manipulate anything based on the null or empty value. We know that this magic variable will give you the correct row as JSON object. Then why can't we use this variable only for my payload? But there's problem. We know that this magic variable will not remove the null values. We need to explicitly write some utility which will eliminate all the null or empty values. So we can create the utility to remove the null values from a JSON object using JavaScript or Java. We are more familiar with the Java, so I'm going to create a Java utility. In my previous videos, I've already explained how to create a Java method and call in your Krate feature file. We have already one utils package. Inside this, I'm going to create a new class called JSON utils. This will be a Java class. I'm going to create a public static method, and the return type of this method will be a string, and I will name it as like remove null keys, and it will take one argument. So the type of argument I am going to have as a map. You will understand why we are keeping it as map. So it will be a string, and values can be anything through object. Since we are using JSON, so I'm going to use the object mapper. Let me create an object of this class. I am going to use the entry set so that I can apply stream and remove the null value. So JSON object dot entry set. Now I can call the stream, and I'll call the filter method. So in this filter method, I'm going to filter all the null values. So use the entry dot get value. If it is not equal to null, keep it. And also I'm going to add one more thing for empty. Entry dot get value not equal to empty. When you use the CSV, then we get the empty string. That's why I'm adding both the conditions. After filtering, I'm going to collect it as map only. So collector dot to map, and here I need to pass like entry. First thing will be my key, so entry dot get key, and second one will be my value, so entry dot get value. Since I am keeping the return type of this method as a string, so I am going to convert this map into a string. So let me store into a variable thing object JSON without null. I can use return statement with the object mapper dot write value as string, and here I can pass the JSON without null object. This is going to throw an exception, so let me handle it. So this will work for the simple JSON object where we don't have nested thing, but if you have nested one, you need to write some complex logic for this. And now I'm going to overload this method, and instead of accepting map argument, I am going to accept a string. So if this is a string, then we cannot directly call the entry set. First thing, we need to convert this JSON object, which is a string, to a map. For that, again I can use object mapper dot read value. I can pass JSON object, which is string, and then I can pass the new type def, and here I just need to pass map of string object. Let me use these two methods in my feature file. So I'm not going to use this now. I will print value of underscore underscore raw, and after this I am going to call my Java function. We already know to call a class we need to use java.type, and here you need to pass the full package name. So JSON utils class is present in examples.airline.utils. So let me copy this package name, then pass the class name, which is JSON utils. Don't pass any extension, and this I need to store into a variable. After this, I can call the method from my JSON utils class. Since these are static, so no need to create any object of this, just simply call the method. So let me use the remove null values and pass the underscore underscore raw, and output of this I am going to store into JSON object, and I am going to print JSON object now. I will print the underscore underscore row as well. Let me run this. So from the JSON, we are not passing the ID, right? We are passing ID as null. So the first one is underscore underscore raw. It will give you the data as it is. Then we are going to remove the null values using the Java method, and this we are printing in JSON object. So which you can see here, and you can see here we don't have the ID, and again we are printing the underscore underscore raw. And you can see it is as it is. Now let's come back why we have created two methods. So let me show you the type of underscore underscore raw variable. So I'm going to use math. What I'm expecting, the type of this variable is a string. So underscore underscore raw should be equal to fuzzy matcher, which is string. Let me run and see the output. So if you see the output, it's saying that right hand side we have map, which we are trying to compare with the string. That's why I have created a method which is accepting a map. But suppose I want to pass as a string, so we can use karate dot to string method to convert the map to string. Karate dot to string and pass this variable. I will comment this match statement so that it should go through. Let me run it now. So this time also you can see it is removing the null values. So I will duplicate this for CSV file. In CSV file also I have the same column name, so there's no need to change anything. And here instead of passing the JSON file, I need to pass the CSV file. So CSV file is also present in my payloads folder in the same location. So I just change the name, and if I run it, it will run perfectly fine. So here you can see it is reading the data from my CSV. Let me show you how it will behave with the empty cell. If you open this file into CSV, you will not see any value here because I have removed the cell value. Now I will show you how it is behaving with the empty cell. Let me rerun the scenario and show you the output. See, if I go to first row of data where I am not passing the ID field, you can see it is giving you the data where ID is empty string. So that is the reason I have added two conditions in my Java utils method. If I duplicate this scenario for my CSV file, and here I will just change CSV. Here also I need to pass the CSV file name. And if I run this scenario now, you can see that it will remove the ID field because ID has empty string value. So let's go to first row of data, and here you can see it is printing the underscore row, and here it is giving the data after removing the ID field. And again, it is not changing the actual value of the magic variable. So these are the ways we can use JSON and CSV file for data driven testing. So that's all in this video. If you have any doubt, please comment on this video. If you really like my videos, please like, comment, subscribe, and share with others. Thank you, everyone.